This tutorial will help you understand how to write a very simple login program in C++. You'll also learn about a few different constructs within the C++ language. You'll learn about a do-while loop, strings, Boolean data type, and your logical AND and NOT operators. Here's the output of a simple program that we're going to write. Notice we're taking in string input and we're allowing the user to keep going until they enter in the correct username and password. Let's take a look at how to do this with C++. So we start off with our typical C++ main function and environment, but since we're working with strings, we need to include the preprocessor directive to string. Now that we have that, I'm ready to establish declare and initialize my variables. I'm going to have a variable named string and call that thing username. Go ahead and initialize it to nothing. And then I'm going to have another string and call that guy password. Initialize that to nothing. And then I'm going to have a Boolean data type. And I'm going to call it login success. I'm going to go ahead and initialize it to false. Recall that the Boolean data type will only work with true and false values. Now I'm going to welcome my user to the program and invite them to go ahead and try and log in below. And now is when I'm going to start my do while loop. Now the format for a do while loop is the keyword do, and then these curly brackets will hold the body of the while loop. Now I have the keyword while. I have parentheses which will hold together the loop continuation test, and then don't forget the semicolon at the end. So what happens with the do while loop is that the set of instructions that I put inside the body are going to automatically execute at least once. So I know I want to give my user at least one try at putting in the correct username and password. So I'll just say cout enter username. Or let's just make it better. Let's just say username. And we're going to input that data into our variable named username. And then we're going to prompt the user for the password. And we're going to put that data into the password variable. Now what I need to do is think about what I want the valid username and password to be. So I'm just going to stay with what I had before and use Heidi and then that H2H2 password. So I'm going to say if username equals Heidi, there's our logical AND, password equals, and then the H2H2 string. Then what I want to do is output the string saying successful login. But there's another thing that I want to make sure I do if the user did log in successfully. I want to make sure that I change that flag value to login success. So they were able to log in. I'm changing login success equal to true because by default I've got it set to false. Now inside my while loop I'm going to say while login success. Now the reason why I would want them to keep going back around and again, around and around is if login success was not true or if login success was false. Therefore, I'm going to negate whatever lives inside login success using my NOT operator. So now I'm ready to enter in the else part. I'm going to say else, and I'm going to have a couple things here. I'm going to say incorrect username, password, combo. Who knows what I'll say there. That's good enough. And then I'm going to prompt my user to try again. And close my curly bracket. And so we'll just look over it real quick, see if we have any problems, and then we will go ahead and try and compile. Let's see what happens. Compile this guy. Welcome, enter below. Let's enter in a bogus username and a bogus password. Incorrect username and password combo. Another bogus one. Incorrect. Another bogus one. All right. Another bogus one. And now let's enter in the correct username and password. Let me just slide over so I can see what that correct password is. And successful login. So in this tutorial, you learned how to work with strings, how to work with the Boolean data type, how to write a repeat until, also called a do while loop, how to work with your not operator as well as your and operator.